Edison?
Yes.
Star.
During the previous deliberation, friends, we have discussed the two types of middlemen, primary participants and ancillary or facilitating participants. As I mentioned earlier, that primary participants are of two types, functional middlemen, they are also known as the mercantile agents, and second is the merchant middlemen. We have discussed about all the aspects of the functional middlemen in our previous deliberation. So, in this deliberation, we should start with the merchant middlemen. What is merchant middlemen? Actually, in our life, in our day-to-day life, we come across with the merchant middlemen. This is the real scenario of the channel members by which we confront every day. Merchant middlemen act on their own right and engaged in buying and selling the goods at a profit. There are two important aspects which should be given proper attention here, my dear friends. Buying and selling activities is performed by the merchant middlemen. The impact of buying and selling activities is the transfer of title from seller to the buyer, from one center, one point to another center. And the motive of this act is to earn the profit. Suppose if the wholesaler buys the commodity from manufacturer and sells to the customers, in this process, manufacturers acquire the title by buying the commodities, and when they sell to the customers, they transfer the title to the customer. In this trade, the merchant middleman bear the risk. Not only that, they also perform the various functions like storing, grading, packaging and packing. If these activities are performed by the middlemen, now the company is free to plan the product and to after developing the product. As I have mentioned that this is the real scenario of the channel members, channel management. The merchant middlemen are of two types, known as wholesaler and retail trader. Now, what is wholesale trader or wholesaler? This is a very common term which we know very, very much, that wholesalers are the persons or the organizations who generally buy the goods from the manufacturers or the agents of the manufacturers, and they sell those goods to the industrial users or retail traders. Students, wholesalers never sell the products to the ultimate consumers. So in this way, we can say that wholesalers act as a middleman between the producer of goods on the one hand and retailers or industrial users on the other. Wholesalers are categorized into three types: based on the merchandise, based on the method of operation, based on the geographic coverage. The first type is based on merchandise. In this, the first category is the general merchandise wholesaler. These are the wholesalers. This type of wholesalers deal with several unrelated types of products. You can take the example of cosmetics and garments. The second is the general line wholesalers. This type of wholesalers deal in number of goods in the same product line. In first type, they may deal with the different product lines and different types of products. But in this category, they deal in number of products in the same product line, like drug wholesaler or hardware wholesaler. The last one is the specialty or single line wholesaler. They always deal in a very specific product, like seafood wholesalers. They are very specific, they deal with very specific products and product lines. The second is the based on the method of operation. In this category, they are categorized, they are classified into two categories: service wholesaler and limited function wholesalers. These service wholesalers offer a variety of services like advertising, grading, branding, packaging on behalf of manufacturers and retailers. In the category of limited function wholesaler, they undertake a few limited functions like cash and carry wholesaler, who sell on cash and does not provide delivery services. Limited function means in the flow of the goods. Suppose if you sell the commodity to anyone, generally, it happens that we make the arrangement of the delivery to the customer. But in this type of, if the wholesaler is performing the limited functions, and then they will sell the commodity on cash basis, but they will not provide the delivery of the services. On the basis of the geographical coverage, the wholesalers are of three types: the local wholesaler, who deals in a particular city or town. Suppose a wholesaler deals only in the Madan Gadi or in Saket or in a particular town, they are known as the local wholesaler. When they deal, when they cover a particular district, they are known as the district wholesaler. And when they deal with the retailers located, spread over in a region or a country, they are known as the regional or national wholesaler. In nutshell, you can say, when the wholesaler deals in a particular city, they are local wholesaler. When they deal in a particular district, they are district wholesaler. When they deal with the retailers spread over in a region or within the boundaries of a country, they are known as the regional or national wholesaler. Now come to the retail trader, retailers. We every day come across the retailers for procurement of our needed products. So retailers are the persons, are the organizations, are the outlets who primarily sell the goods to the consumers for their own use, not for the resale in business. Here I would like to draw your attention that in wholesaler we have studied that wholesalers either sell to the industrial users or to the retailers. If any commodity is sold to a particular person for using them or for resale, that will not fall within the ambit of the retailing. So retailers always sell, makes the sale of the goods to the consumers for their own use, or in other words you can say they sell the goods to the ultimate consumers. Again, we can classify the retailers. Retailers are of two types: itinerant retailers and fixed shop retailers. Itinerant retailers we every day in the market we see the hawkers, peddlers, payment traders and market traders. Retail traders who carry on business moving about from place to place to sell their goods, they do not have any fixed place of business. They either move from house to house or with their goods, or change their place of business frequently according to convenience and sales of products. We always have the experiences that in our mohalla, in our village, there are so many traders who carry on their business on the thelas, on the hawkers, etc. These are the categories. Hawkers are peddlers. They move from door to door, as we know, in residential localities. They generally deal with the vegetables, fruits, utensils, toys, ice creams and snacks. Since they have no the fixed outlets, so they carry goods in bags or trays, on their bicycles or push carts, or small motor vans, say the moped or the horse drawn carriage. Payment retailers generally put up their temporary sheds or makeshift platforms from display of goods. When we go to the in any market,
we observe that there are so many small traders, small retailers, who put up their temporary sheds at a particular time. If you go by the Hazrat Ganj or Connaught Place, on the roadside we observe that there are so many small retailers, traders, who put up their temporary sheds for the period of 2 hours, 3 hours, or in every in evening hours, and they display their goods. We observe that there are so many temporary sheds dealing with the purses, the toys. These are found nearby the busy market areas, street crossings, in front of railway stations and bus terminals. They generally deal with the handbags, cut pieces of clothes, ready-made garments, footwear, household utensils, toys, books and journals, pen and pencils, fruits, vegetables, etc. Market traders. In generally it happens in the rural areas. In rural areas, weekly markets are held. In small towns, weekly markets are held. So this market trader sells their goods in weekly market held in small towns or villages. They move from one market to another in neighboring places on specific days fixed for a market. Suppose if we are from the village, there might be a kasba nearby the village. There might be the more than one or two kasbas. So the every Monday and Friday, suppose, is on every Monday and Friday of every week, the market is held. So on these 2 days, they will sell their goods, and rest of the days they may visit, they may go to the other markets held nearby the village in the another kasbas. Small scale retailers, stalls on streets are there. They set up in front of the large stores or in residential areas, selling a limited variety of products of regular use with the stationery, grocery, toilet and products. In cities we can observe this type of phenomenon. Suppose if we visit a mall, so in front of the mall there are so many stalls put by the small traders dealing with the commodities of the regular use. The second is the general merchandise shops. The general merchandise shops are of small retail stores which deal in all types of general consumer goods of regular use, including provisions, stationery and toys. We generally in our muhallas, in every muhalla there are few outlets, small traders, and they deal with every type of commodities. They sell grocery, they sell the confectionery items, they sell the toys, they sell the stationery, they deal with the sports commodities. So these are known as the general merchandise shops. Specialty shops,
They deal in only one or two special types of goods. Two goods dealt with maybe only electrical fittings and different of different kinds, or medicines, or motor parts, or ready-made garments, or toys. So these are in mohallas, in our mohallas, in nearby markets, we observe that there are certain outlets, the fixed outlets, who deal only the specific products. They deal only in the, either they deal in the sports products, or they sell only the pharmaceutical products. Now, come to the, actually, whatever the types of outlets, or whatever the types of retailers we have studied earlier, they are the small scale retailers. They generally fall within the ambit of the informal sector. Informally, they deal with the trading services. They deal with the flow of commodities. But besides that, there is another scenario that is more organized, that is known as the organized retail sector. And this organized retail sectors, we find the large scale retail shops in different formats, in different types, known as the departmental stores, supermarket, multiple shops or chain shops, mail order business, consumer cooperative societies, higher purchase traders, discount bazaars, automatic vending machines and super bazaars. What is departmental store? A departmental store is a large scale institution comprising a number of departments. Each department deals in a separate line of products. These all departments perform their trading activities, their buying and selling activities under one roof, under the one control. The very common examples are the Big Bazaar and Spencer's, which are found in India, where we can find whole range of goods in one building run under one control. The another supermarket, that is, and the super bazaars. These are the second type of large retail stores which deal in a variety of products under a single roof. These stores are operated either on the principle of self-service or with the separate counters served by the salesman. Now, at this point, we should understand super bazaar is organized by the cooperative societies, whereas the supermarket is generally established as a private sector organization, but in an organized way. The another category is the multiple shops or chain store, that is very popular in India, and we have been experiencing the Bata shoe stores. That is a very popular example of the multiple shops or chain stores. The organization which controls a number of stores under one common ownership and management. These multiple shops or chain stores can be operated by manufacturer or by the wholesalers or with the basic with the basic objective of eliminating the retailers. Remind your memory, at the beginning point of our deliberation, I have pointed out that there are two types of middlemen, or there are two types of channel of distribution, direct and indirect. So this multiple shops or chain stores are the best example of the direct channel of distribution. In order to eliminate all the intermediaries or the middlemen between the manufacturer and the consumers, the manufacturers generally establish the chain stores and they try to reach the customer directly so that they can eliminate the malpractices or the ill practices adopted by the intermediaries just to exploit the innocent customers. Mail order house, though this is not today, nowadays it is very common, but in this type of retailing we put the order through the postage and telegraphs, and the delivery of the product is made by BPP, value payable post. Now this is replaced by the online retailing. The consumer cooperative stores, in this type of large scale retailers, the consumers join together, they form the cooperative societies and sell the goods to their members on retail basis. The basic purpose of this forming the consumer cooperative stores is to eliminate middlemen and obtain the required commodities and services at a lower price. An example of cooperative store is Central Government Employees Consumers Cooperative Stores, higher purchase traders. This is very important, we must understand. You know that there are two methods of selling the commodities. The one is the cash on cash basis, the second is the credit basis. On the cash basis, the seller sells the commodities to the buyer, to the customer, and gets the payment from the customer. Automatically at that point of time, the title or the ownership of the commodity is transferred from seller to the buyer. But there is another type of the sales, that is a credit sales. In credit sales, we postpone the payment of the price of the commodity. Generally, this credit sales, in case of the credit sales, the payments are made in installments. Installments may be monthly, weekly, fortnightly, third monthly, yearly, whatever may be. But in this type of higher purchase system, or in higher purchase system, the seller transfers the possession of the commodity to the buyer. The buyer makes the payment in installments, but the ownership, the buyers do not get the ownership until the last payment has been made. Here I would like to mention the another type of the installment, that is the installment payment system, in which the possession and title,
both are transferred from seller to the buyer, though the payment is made in future installments, might be weekly, might be third monthly, quarterly, might be half yearly, might be yearly. So there is a difference between the hire purchase system and between the installment payment system. In hire purchase system, the buyer gets only the possession of the commodity, makes the payment in the future, but they do not get the ownership until the last payment installment is made, has been made or is made. But in case of the installment payment system, the ownership and title of the goods is automatically transferred from seller to the buyer when they make the agreement of buying and selling of the commodities. Though in this type of credit sales, the payment is made in installments in future. Discount stores, this is a very popular form nowadays. In this, the large scale retail establishments which generally offer the discounts on the prices, known as the discount houses. They sell in every mohalla, in every we are the citizen of the Delhi, we can observe in every market there is a huge crowd of customers visiting the discount houses or this discount stores. In this discount stores, the retailers deal with the a large number of commodities of the same product line or of the different product line, and they charge very lower price. They they transfer the commodities accepting the lower margins, but they sell in higher volumes. Automatic vending machines, the best example of the tickets, metro tickets, in every metro station the automatic vending machines are there. In organized retailing outlets, automatic vending machines are there. We can get the our we can get the articles with the help of coin operated automatic machines. Cigarettes, razor blades, postage stamps, milk, ice cream, soft drinks, soup, paperback books, newspapers are sold in cities through vending machines. So to conclude with, we can say both consumers and producers are benefited by the services of middlemen, as they constantly match the supply and demand in the market. It is also believed that as goods pass hands from one middleman to other, their prices inflate, but the services of middlemen cannot be ignored, and they are important players in every market. In COVID-19 pandemic situation, we have a lot of experiences and about the role of the small retailers, the peddlers, the hawkers. In that pandemic period, they were only the platforms, they were only the centers where we were getting our essential commodities. So though their involvement inflate the price, but their services cannot be ignored, because the prompt delivery or the prompt, the right, the flow of the goods are goods. If the producer or marketer wants to make the constant delivery distribution of the products at the right time or at the right place at the convenient time, is the role of middleman cannot be ignored. With these words, I would like to finish our deliberations. Thank you one and all for hearing. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Hello students, today we are going to make the deliberation on a very interesting and very
important aspect of the marketing, that is channel of distribution or distribution channels, also known as the channel management.